My Mayor Raúl, how are you this morning, sir?
Good morning. Good morning, Judge and Commissioners. Raúl Reyes, County Treasurer, for the record. Your Honor, this morning I have two items. I have the presentation of bills and disbursements, and of course, the monthly report for the month of January 2023. For the period of February 10th, 2023 through February 23rd, 2023, we did receive and review 485 invoices, for which 245 checks have been processed, and that disbursement amount is $507,030.15. We did receive review 434 invoices, in which electronic fund transfers were processed, and that total amount was 129, and that disbursement total is $772,647.19, all of which are waiting for approval to be released. Prior to today's meeting, as per the general order, we did process 69 checks for the payment of 172 invoices, and that disbursement total amount was $203,393.31. And of course, that is for the energy assistance vouchers, materials and supplies, routine expenditures, trainings, lease contracts, and utilities. I don't know if you have any questions on this first part.
Any questions or comments, colleagues?
Yes, sir.
None to be had. Do you need a...
Yes, to go ahead and release the payments.
Yeah, someone second.
Is that the first time you haven't had any electronic transfer?
For the general order, yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Good observation. Motion second. Any opposed? Motion carries. You may proceed, sir.
Because the majority of them, Commissioner, and I'm glad you noted it, they're just energy assistance vouchers, you know, that you pay directly to the electric companies. The next is the payment ratifications. We did have some requests from various offices as late as last Friday. And of course, we take these on a case-to-case scenario. But unfortunately, there are some unforeseen circumstances where payments need to be made. If not, you know, it disrupts county operations or department operations. So we did process 81 checks for the payment of 155 invoices, and that disbursement total was $219,644.38. I'm sorry. And then we had one electronic fund transfer for the payment of two invoices, and that amount was $168,406.86. You'll see there that we had one forfeiture, 71 tax refunds, and of course, we had some requests from the department. In the next slide, you'll see those departments and the amounts with respects to what was actually disbursed. I don't know if you have any questions regarding the payment ratification.
Any questions?
No, and for this, I would need action to.
So moved as well.
Second.
Second by Commissioner Hyman. Motion second. Any opposed? Motion carries.
So the next item is just the payroll disbursement of county payroll, the liability disbursements. And it's just for informational purposes only. For the pay period of January 27th through February 9th, 2023, we had two payroll runs. One was the normal regular one, and that one was the payment of 2,017 employees, and that disbursement total was $4,526,848.90. And then we had another special payroll, and that disbursement total, of course, with all the liabilities included, was $784.85. The next and last item in this portion is the Casablanca Golf Course requirement of funds. The previous approved estimate was $40,000, and that was for the pay date of February 24th. The actual amount was $33,676.50. And then this new pay date coming up on the 10th of March, we estimate about $40,000 once again for the requirement of funds.
So I'm moving to approve that not to exceed $40,000.
Second, with just discussion real quick, and Commissioner Gallo, just for the public to know, the gratuity is just gratuity. It is not commission. Is that correct?
That is correct.
Okay.
Yes. And my understanding, Your Honor.
Good question.
Is that I think they have temporarily halted, you know, bonuses and commissions, if I'm not
mistaken. So that's just pure gratuity from the people out there?
That is correct. That is that those are the tips that are included in when they close out their credit cards.
Very good. Motion and second. Any opposed? Motion carries. Thank you. Good question.
My next item is the January 2023 monthly report. This report was submitted electronically by my chief deputy county treasurer on Friday. And judge and commissioners, if you require a hard copy, please let us know, and we're more than glad to, you know, provide.
Actually, saving paper is pretty good, yes. So I'm okay with that.
And of course, my presentation is just a recap of the actual content of the information in detail provided in my report. For the month of January 2023, at the end of the month, our cash balance was $224,458,276.29. Our investment portfolio was $60,910,902.51. And of course, our total investment portfolio at the end of January is on your screen. It's $285,369,178.80. We did reconcile all of the accounts, so we're up to date. I want to thank those departments that, you know, expedited their pending issues. I know that when that happens, the auditor is happy as well. And just for record purposes, you'll see there that we do reconcile 21 accounts, and then we do 13 for the tax assessor collector, and then one for the elections office.
And is the election office all up to date now?
Yes.
All right, very good.
So we have some good news in
great
terms
news.
Of our in terms of our
good news, great news. That number
interest
pops
rate
up.
by financial institution this month, we were able to receive an investment income $542,068. If you look at the actual report that was provided to you on Friday, you'll see that when we started the fiscal year, that income was $297,588. And then last month, it was $488,512. This month, $542,068. And of course, that's attributed to the increase in rates. If you'll see there in the next, yeah, there you go. The previous slide, I'm sorry. Previous? There you go. Our tax pool rate is at 4.2443%. Multi-bank securities, the weighted average, which we have not invested new monies into, is 1.9200%. Falcon International Bank, because of the increase, went up by 1 percentage point, and that now it's at 2.5000%. And then you have Faro Wealth. At the same time, and I do apologize, that Faro Wealth is supposed to be 2.5060%. I'm guessing that the slide wasn't updated.
It is.
It is.
Oh, and then my report is the wrong one. I apologize for that.
That's correct here.
Yeah, so it's 2.5060%. And of course, the Texas class, which we've slowly reinvested into, and you can see why. It's at 4.5742%, and of course, our Greater Pacific Securities that we have, our new brokerage, is at 4.1870%. So we're almost live with Clear Waters, so I'm excited to share the link with y'all pretty soon so y'all can see real time all of the county's investments and how much money it's generated on, you know, a month-to-month basis per security and when the maturity of these investments are. So that's going to be something pretty exciting. And this is the recap of our investment portfolio, Judge and Commissioners, and you'll see there how much money is invested in each of the different entities. The next slide is a checks issued report, and
excuse
of course—
excuse me real quick. Yes. I don't know why it's getting to me today. David, do you mind closing that door, please? I appreciate it. Thank you.
So this report encompasses our January 9th, 2023 meeting, January 23rd, 2023 meeting, and the January 13th, 2023 meeting. And you'll see that we had some accounts payable, payroll, and payroll liabilities. The total disbursement amount was $14,937,688.89. And that is section three. The next section, Judge and Commissioners, is our sales tax revenue, which is also some pretty exciting news. Just in the month of January 2023, our sales tax income was $2,413,422. That revenue is in an increase of $1,397,305 from the previous, from what was budgeted. So we're above $1.3 million of what was budgeted for sales tax income just in January 2023. In comparison to last year, that represents an increase of $775,000, which is 32.13%.
Remind me on the trend during the year out of the four quarters, when is our least amount of money that we can get in for sales tax?
The least amount of money that we have
generally
seen
average
in terms of our trend, you'll probably see it within May, June.
Say June.
Okay. May, June.
But being up 1.something million, that's pretty substantial, isn't it?
Yeah, that's
you're wanting a hug, right? That's what you're wanting.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You're wanting a hug,
yeah,
right?
That's what y'all want. Y'all want to make sure that y'all are above and just to put it into perspective, we did anticipate $3 million overage above what the previous fiscal year, and right now, just in these 4 months alone, we're already at $2.5 million.
Oh, great!
So we still have some more months, which I think we're gonna, you know, be very good in terms of that. In terms of our bingo and mixed beverage tax, our bingo tax collected for the period of October and December was $9,131.50. Our mixed beverage tax portion, that amount continues to increase month by month. For the month of January, we had some heavy drinkers, I'm guessing, at the bars. That amount was $68,626.46. The previous Cheers. Month was $62,000. When we started in October, it was $60,000. So that total amount right now is $254,724.43. In terms of our Webb County rents report, we did receive in rents $4,757.61, and then we paid out $23,289.54. And in your report, you'll see the full details of where that money is going to. Leases paid, we're done with paying annual leases, so now we're paying month by month. So you'll see there why that decrease. And for the month of January, our total lease debt service payment was $47,353.56. The permanent school fund keeps on getting bigger. I know that y'all approved at the last meeting the disbursements, right? If I'm not mistaken. The total revenue for the month of January 31st, 2023 was $433,826.96. And that portion came from the Highway 44 royalties and the Highway 59 royalties. No damages were reported, and of course the hunting and grazing payments, you'll see there when they're due accordingly. The balance at the end of January 31st, 2023 in the permanent school fund is $4,242,894.38. And you'll see the royalties for permanent school fund schedule in your report as well, and of course the disbursements. The next slide I think the judge will like the best, and that is our Tex-Mex parking lot.
Hey, right. Bill, come here, hold on. Hold on.
Oh my goodness, I get a hug.
I love that.
It's a lot.
Just because we can put money.
You know what that hug means, though, right?
I'm sorry?
You know what that hug means, right? Next month has to be higher.
It has to be higher? Okay.
It better continue. It better continue.
To be quite honest and frank with you, the Tex-Mex parking lot has really been, you know, an endeavor in itself, right? Last month we had an issue with the server, and I'm so grateful to our staff at the office for being so prompt and quick and making sure that they reach out to the technicians to get these things, you know, fixed, because it's very important. Because if not, you lose money.
What do you attribute that double in income?
I'm sorry?
What do you attribute the doubling income?
You know, I think more people are realizing that the parking lot is available for county business, and
do we need signage?
I was going
to
say,
I would say that we need to do a better job and
get some signage from public parking and advertise the rates.
Mm-hmm. We could tell.
And I think what I want to
right there, we'll figure it out.
Yeah, and maybe perhaps speaking to the district judges, the tax assessor, collector, and letting them tell their customers, you know, you can use that parking, you know, it's free for an hour. After that, you know, there is a rate. But, you know, even at that, you know, we had 1,427 tickets that were closed. So just take this into perspective, 687 of them were below the hour, so we didn't receive any income on them. 756 of them, you know, we did receive income.
That's 600-something people that were able to benefit.
That were able to benefit, yes.
Provided, go in there and do their business and get out and go, not have to.
That is correct. And we would have surpassed the 5,000 threshold, Your Honor, but we do provide vouchers for jury duty, and that amount is listed there. That was, you know, an offset of $766.
We're moving on up.
And Judge and Commissioners, that is all I have this morning for you.
All right, good report.
Thank you.
Everybody want
to motion to
accept?
What is it, receive?
Accept report.
Second.
Motion second. Any opposed? Motion carries. Thank you.
Thank you, and y'all have a great work week.
All right, before...